Hello guys, Sanjay here and welcome back to a new video in which we are going to compare two very strong contenders for the budget of 15,000. MI-A1 is available at 14,000 and Honor 7X is available at 13,000 for the 32GB internal storage variant. Without wasting any time, let's start with looks and build quality. 18x9 displays is the new trend and 7X is following that with very small bezels and a huge screen, whereas MI-A1 is having big bezels in the front. Honor 7X surely looks and feels very premium in hands, but MI-A1 is not far behind though. Metal back on the MI-A1 feels good to hold too. And overall build quality is great on both devices, but Honor 7X steals the show. Both devices support dual SIM cards, but none of them have a dedicated microSD card slot, which is a bummer in the era of Jio. You can use dual 4G on MI-A1, but Honor 7X does not support dual 4G. If you're using 4G in one SIM card slot, then the other one will switch to 2G. Honor 7X does not support 5GHz Wi-Fi 2. I mean, what? Are we in 2017 or 2015? MI-A1 supports dual 4G and 5GHz Wi-Fi, so it gets the point even though call quality was super fine on both devices with Jio 4G, VoLTE and 2G and 3G networks. MI-A1 is having 3000mAh battery as compared to Honor 7X's 3300mAh, but both these devices will get you through a day and both of them produce similar results, which will give you 4 to 5 hours of screen on time with moderate to heavy usage. And if you are a very light user, then you can get through a day and half of the other day most probably. Almost every budget phone launched in 2017 performed very well in battery department, but when it comes to charging time, it's totally different story, as MI-A1 will take at least 2 hours to charge completely from 0 to 100% and Honor 7X takes minimum of 2 hours and 30 minutes, and I tried to charge both devices with Quick Charger 3.0, but no, nothing worked. Sometimes Honor 7X took almost 3 hours to charge completely even with the Quick Charge 3.0 charger. USB Type-C is the future and MI-A1 is having one. Whereas Honor 7X is still having micro USB port. Not a huge deal, but I want every phone to have USB Type-C port in 2018. Both devices keep headphone jack, thank God for that, but MI-A1's DAC takes the notch one level up, even though speaker on MI-A1 is much better than one on the Honor 7X. If you are so-called audiophile, then get the MI-A1. Sound quality is not bad on the Honor 7X, but MI-A1 easily beats the 7X. It took me and many app developers a lot of time to adjust to the new 18x9 displays, but after using Pixel 2, OnePlus 5T, Mimix 2 and now the Honor 7X, I can easily say that it's great experience to have big displays with small bezels. And on top of that, Honor 7X's display is much vivid and saturated as compared to MI-A1. So the 7X's display is much better as compared to MI-A1. MI-A1's display is good but not as vivid as Honor 7X or even the Redmi Note 4. View angles and outdoor visibility on both devices was really good for the price, and thankfully none of them is having a HD screen. Both of them have at least full HD displays. Difference between software on MI-A1 and 7X is like white and black. MI-A1 is having pure stock Android, which will be updated directly by Google. And before you go like, let me tell you that Redmi Note 4 with MIUI 9 with same specifications was able to beat MI-A1. Even though I believe stock Android on the MI-A1 is snappy, but there is surely room for improvement, similar to Honor 7X. 7X did and will outperform the MI-A1 in speed tests, but for a regular user, it will be very difficult to differentiate between these two phones. EMUI on the Honor 7X is totally customized version of Android and has loads of features which do work really well. I have made a video on all the EMUI features, which will be linked in the description box below. 7X surely feels very snappy, but I did notice few stutters in the UI which can be easily fixed with a software update, and I'm sure Honor will fix those very, very minor issues soon. But there is one thing which Honor can't fix, and that's the absence of gyroscope sensor. So if you are a VR freak or if you are planning to use VR, then better buy the MI-A1. MI-A1 is supposed to be quick to receive software updates as it is part of Android One program, but it is yet to receive Android Oreo update, whereas OnePlus 3, 3T have already received it. MI-A1 will be a better device if you need monthly security updates and longer software support, as I don't think so that Honor will be providing a huge software support for the Honor 7X. Gaming performance on the MI-A1 is very consistent as compared to Honor 7X. So if you are someone who is going to game a lot, then MI-A1 should be a better choice as compared to 7X. Kirin 659 is not a very popular processor among developers, so do not expect great custom ROM development for Honor 7X. Whereas MI-A1 will be having a bright future even though Xiaomi is procrastinating when it comes to releasing kernel sources, and I hate that. Camera. this is where it becomes even more interesting. Here are some sample shots with the rear facing camera of both devices, and both of them are very comparable side by side. Details are preserved in both devices in good lighting conditions. Selfies clicked with the Honor 7X have more details in good lighting conditions as compared to MI11. If selfie is your topmost priority, then you are better off buying the 7X due to amount of details present in low lighting conditions as well. Portrait mode is amazing on the MI1 as it clicks much natural looking portraits as compared to Honor 7X. Honor 7X's portrait mode is totally software based, so if you click more portraits, then you know which device to buy. Don't buy the Honor 7X for portrait mode. Low lighting conditions are always challenging for budget oriented devices, but Honor 7X tries its best to keep details. You'll notice that some pictures look better on MI1 and some are better on the 7X. So I would say that it's a tie in low lighting conditions, but MI1 did click little bit brighter pictures as it was clicking those pictures at higher ISO. So if you do not want to use the Pro mode on Honor 7X, or if you do not want to use Snapseed, then in low lighting conditions, I believe that MI1 can be a better choice, even though it's a very neck-to-neck competition. The best thing that I can recommend you to do is download the Snapseed application, add a little bit of saturation, add a little bit of contrast, decrease or increase the highlights and shadows. Your picture will look much better with few minor things which are going to take almost 10 to 20 seconds to edit. And if you want a detailed tutorial on Snapseed, then do let me know about that in the comment section box below. Fingerprint sensor response on Honor 7X is much faster as compared to MI11. And even after multiple software updates, Google did not improve the fingerprint performance. I mean, what is Google doing? Because of this, I'm thinking that if MI11 was launched with MIUI 9, basically MI5X, then it would have performed much better as compared to how it is performing with the stock Android. Like, it's not performing bad, but there is a lot of potential present in MI11 which is not being unleashed by Google. Now let's talk about the video recording capabilities of both these devices. This video is being recorded with the Honor 7X and the audio is from the Honor 7X. And this video is from the MI1 and audio is from the MI1. But Honor 7X cannot record at 4K, whereas MI1 can record at 4K. None of these devices are having EIS stability in them. So if you are planning to shoot videos while walking, theirs are not going to be very stable.
When it comes to focusing while recording a video, I believe that Honor 7X is much better as compared to MI11, because MI11 is having sort of like focus hunting issue which is not present in the Honor 7X. It's much subtle on the Honor 7X. And overall, I think that both these cameras did perform good.
But if you need 4K videos, then you have to go with MI11 as Honor 7X does not support that. And that's pretty much it for the comparison between Honor 7X and the Xiaomi MI11. Which one should you choose? If you are not into map stuff, because gyroscope sensor is not present in the Honor 7X, then you have to go with MI11 as there is no other choice. But if you think that you are okay with not having a gyroscope sensor and you are not going to use any type of VR stuff and you are not going to travel somewhere where you are going to stand and you need a direction, then go with the Honor 7X. It has much better display, a faster fingerprint sensor, and a feature packed UI which is not slow at all.
I had used the Honor 8 Pro earlier and the UI on that device was really good too. Why should you buy the MI1? Then if you are someone who listens to a lot of songs and is an audiophile, then go with the MI1. Plus, software support is going to be long lasting for the MI1 as it is supported by Google. If you are still confused which device to buy, then I would highly recommend you to make a list of points that you want in a device and give a point to each device. Whichever device wins, go with that one, because I believe that both these devices are so good that even if you buy the Honor 7X or the Xiaomi MI11, you are going to be happy with both of them. Once again, MI11 can record 1080p videos with the front-facing camera, whereas
Honor 7X is stuck on 720p. And I have both these phones at the same distance and still field of view with the Honor 7X is much larger as compared to MI1. MI1 is already cutting my head, so being a 720p video in 2017 with the front-facing camera is a huge deal in my opinion, because 1080p is like the standard even in low budget end phones. And when it comes to front-facing video quality, you be the judge. You can see both these videos, how they perform. And when I walk like this, this is how the video looks on the MI1, whereas this is how the video looks on the Honor 7X.
And when it comes to rear facing camera, Honor 7X does make your video look little bit reddish or adds little bit of saturation with the rear facing camera. But with the Mi 1, it's more natural, but it's not as detailed as Honor 7X in my opinion. Even though both of these do not perform very well when it comes to video recording capabilities.
If you enjoyed this video, then don't forget to give this video a huge thumbs up, and let's see if we can reach 3500 likes on this video. So yeah, thank you guys. Thank you for watching.